According to the headlines, intermittent fasting helps you burn fat and improves your blood pressure, gut health, even brain function. Sign me up. Only one problem. It's a study in mice. We see this online all the time, preliminary results being extrapolated, often to sell something. Science advances slowly, but who wants to wait years for confirmation and human trials?
Ain't nobody got time for that.
So what do we know about the human health benefits of intermittent fasting? Well, it can help with weight loss. After fasting, most people eat more than normal, but not enough to compensate for the fasting period. So overall, there's a calorie deficit. So is intermittent fasting better than any other method of calorie reduction? In most studies, it's equally effective for weight loss and the usual benefits that come with it, like better glucose levels and blood lipids. So for people looking to lose some extra fat, yeah, intermittent fasting may be a viable option. Some people prefer the simplicity of the time window instead of worrying about what they eat all the time. But that simplicity can turn into a trap because we have two food problems in our society. Okay, we got a lot more than that, but two main ones. Most of us eat too much, too many calories. That's an issue. But the main issue is we eat too much of the wrong foods. Now, I know that doesn't apply to you. I'm sure everybody watching this video binges on arugula. But that's not the norm out there. Most popular diets focus on the quantity angle. Low fat and low carb restrict a nutrient, low calorie obviously restricts calories, and intermittent fasting restricts everything. But intermittent fasting says nothing about quality, which is our number one issue. In fact, if you fix quality, you automatically fix quantity. A diet rich in whole foods and fiber is naturally calorie dilute, so we're satiated without overeating calories. So it solves both problems. Of course, fixing quality is not the only way to control calories. All of these can work for weight loss. So intermittent fasting is similar to these approaches in the sense that there's nothing inherently wrong with it as long as we don't lose track of the main issue. Focusing too much on when I eat might distract me from what I eat. And some studies suggest this may indeed happen. In this trial, fasting was effective for weight loss, but once the study was over, people gained a lot of the weight back. A second group was put on a healthy diet of whole foods, high in fiber, and low in saturated fat. After the study, they were more successful at maintaining a healthier lifestyle, including a healthier diet, and keeping the weight off than the group that just fasted. Now, that doesn't have to be the case. Some studies show good maintenance of body weight following intermittent fasting. And of course, we could just keep fasting on and off forever to keep the weight off. But one concern is we don't really know what intermittent fasting does long term. Most of the studies are relatively short. Sure, our ancestors fasted all the time because they were forced to. So it's possible that doing it long term won't be a problem, but we don't know for sure until we have those results. The point is, if you're gonna do it, use it as an extra tool in your arsenal, not a crutch. Trying to fast to undo the damage of an unhealthy diet is like putting really nice curtains on a house that's crumbling down. The main problem is not the fasting, it's the feasting. In fact, depending on someone's personality, it could even backfire. Just like sometimes we're tempted to eat worse after working out because we feel like we earned it, intermittent fasting could have the same psychological effect if we're not careful. I would probably feel less guilty binging today if I fasted all day yesterday. So I have nothing against it, but bear the caveats in mind. Quality is paramount, and if you do decide to fast, check with your doctor first, especially if you have a condition like diabetes, eating disorders, if you're pregnant, or if you're taking any meds. Also, there are many types of intermittent fasting out there. There's alternate day intermittent fasting, or 50-50. There's a 5-2 version, where you eat normal for 5 days and fast for two. There's the 25-5, where you fast for 5 days a month. There's the 16-8, where you fast for 16 hours a day, and you eat in the 8-hour time window. I know, it's a mess. I've seen less numbers on tax returns. So to keep this simple, today we're covering extended fasting for a full day or more. And next time we'll talk about meal timing, the effect of eating in the morning versus at night, some fascinating results there. Okay, what about other benefits beyond weight loss? If I'm already at a healthy weight, does intermittent fasting help me at all? About a year ago, I went to a conference in LA all on intermittent fasting, experts from all over the world presenting their work. This German researcher was presenting some fascinating results. Intermittent fasting helping with weight loss, lowering blood pressure, glucose levels, cholesterol, amazing stuff. But everybody in nutrition science knows that these are changes you often see when people shift to a healthier diet. So I asked the obvious question, are the benefits due to fasting specifically, or are they a result of removing the unhealthy foods people were eating in the first place? In other words, if somebody's already on a pretty healthy diet, does intermittent fasting offer any benefits? I will never forget his answer. In front of 500 people, he said they specifically recruit subjects on a standard Western diet. Lots of Wurst, he said. And we don't like vegans because they dilute our results. Anecdotes aside, the majority of intermittent fasting studies look at overweight subjects with metabolic issues. That makes perfect sense for a study of weight loss. but it doesn't tell us much about the benefits of fasting for a healthy individual. Now, I'm not ruling out additional benefits of fasting beyond just the calories and the body fat. We see them in mouse studies, and some isolated human trials show interesting observations here and there, but overall, studies show similar benefits for intermittent fasting and calorie control. So to me, this suggests that there's nothing magical about fasting per se. If it had some special effect, we would consistently see it outperform the run-of-the-mill calorie reduction approaches. But for the most part, we don't. Maybe future studies will change that, but for now, that's where we are. So does that mean it's 100% about what I eat and when I eat is completely irrelevant? Not so fast. Get it? Fast? Sorry. There are some fascinating studies on meal timing, eating in the morning versus at night, and we're gonna cover those in part two, which is gonna be right here once it's released. And if you're subscribed, you're gonna get the notification, of course, or you can check out this video where I talk about what foods are health promoting and why. Before she ever would say.